This video is an answer to mxoyo's question on Reddit regarding opening doors using some sort of trigger. I will cover the simplest method you can ever imagine, as well I will make the triggers a separate object which will open only doors with matching ID. For this explanation, I use the third person template, and the first thing to do is to create a new actor called door. And after opening, let's add a scene and a cube afterwards. Let's change the size of our cube so it will look like some sort of doors. Also, let's create a second scene that will work as a hinge. We are using it because the cube has its pivot point in the center, and when we will attach it to the hinge, it will stick to it, and so we can simply make the rotation different. Let's place our doors on the map so we can see how it looks. The next thing we need is the trigger. For that we can use a collision shape, and in this case it's gonna be another cube. Let's rescale and reposition until it satisfies us, and when we are done, let's actually start coding something. First, let's make sure we have the collision box selected and scroll down the settings until we see the events. What we need is the overlap begin and overlap end to trigger opening and closing the doors. Once we have the events there, let's place a cast to our third person character. We need this to recognize if the actor that overlapped the box is in fact our character, and if yes, it will go through the top output pin, otherwise it will go through the cast failed output. Right after the cast, we'll use a timeline to create an animation for opening and closing the door. First, let's change the time to 2 seconds and add a float track which we'll call rotation. Now hold left shift and click on the graph to add a point. Set the time and value for this one to 0, and now let's create a second point. Set the time to 2 seconds and value to 90, as we want the door to rotate that much degrees. Use those two buttons to rescale the graph and right click on both points to change how the line behaves to make it look nicer and smoother. As the timeline has been set up, let's now use the rotation value that will be updated over time to actually open the door. Let's grab the hinge while holding the Ctrl key to get the value, and from this node pull out searching for set rotation and select the set local rotation. We don't need to change every value here, we only need the Z value to open and close the doors, so let's right click on the rotator, split the values into 3 floats and connect the rotation with Z value. Now for the overlap end event, we again have to cast to make sure it will only react to our character and connect it into the reverse node. And now it's time for a little test. It works as intended, and it's the easiest setup you can make for doors, but how about making something a bit more advanced? Let's set up a system where a separate actor blueprint will open doors that have the same ID. To do so, let's remove the overlap events and change them with custom events we will name accordingly. And also add one event more to show a message whenever door with a wrong ID will be found. Also, we need the ID itself, so let's head to the variables and create a new one. By default, it's a boolean, and what we need is an integer instead, so let's quickly change that. When we look on our door, it doesn't show anything special, but if we go back and select instance editable and expose on spawn, we will see this variable when we have the actor selected, which is great, because we can now simply place multiple doors on the map and assign a unique ID to every of them. We will not use the old trigger anymore, so let's delete it as well, and that's it for that blueprint. Now let's create a new actor that we will call door opener. Now in the new actor, let's add a scene, afterwards a cube which we will rescale a bit, and again a collision box. Now we need to make same thing as before, add overlap events and make the casts, but now we want to have multiple doors on the map, so let's place some all around. We also need the ID variable here as well to compare if it's the same as of the door. After we have this variable, we will call a function called getAllActorsOfClass and filter only by our door. This node returns an array, which basically is a list of found doors, so we can run a loop through all of the found items. We don't need a cast here because this function will return the door reference directly, so we already have access to it. What we need is the ID of the door, which we can simply pull out from the array element. Once we have this, let's get the ID of the door opener and compare those numbers. The branch we created will give us the opportunity to separate all wrong doors from the correct one. Now let's pull out again from the array element and find the open door event to make it happen when the ID is same on both trigger and door. In case it should not match the ID, we will see the message we programmed before. To prevent making same code checking for every door on the map, we can make some simple trick here. Let's save the information about the door every time we step on the trigger, so we can use the closeDoor function on the same door when we will leave the trigger. Simply right-click on the array element and select promote to variable. We will save it only when we step on a plate that found any door with the same ID and use that information to close the door we lastly opened. I will use a node called isValid here to make sure there is any valid door to close. Now, as we have the code ready, let's place the triggers around the map and assign some values to them and the doors and see the result. I hope that solves your issue. If you need anything else, head over to the About section to get the link to my Discord so I can support you further from there. Stay strong and I wish you a big success with your prototype. Peace!